Thank you for a very promising speech, Your Excellency, the Governor of Edo State. And it just confirms the dream I had last night that the relics and the artifacts forcefully taken from Benin Kingdom over 100 years ago will be returned. Thank you, Your Excellency, for confirming my dream. Oba Atokpe. Okay, so the executive producer of the book is Omogo Omonoenegbe Okpioba Osa Okumbo, who will now give a speech. Please welcome him.
President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, ably represented by the Secretary to Government, Mr. Boss Mustafa, the chairman of this occasion, our father, General Yakubu Gowon, Go On With One Nigeria. The Executive Governor of Edo State, my own brother, Ogenebo Godwin Oyase Obaseki. My royal father, His Majesty Omonoba Edo Okuakwolokwolo, Oba Eware II, the former president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, my own brother and friend, Dr. Ebele Jonathan, who once told us in this country that it's no Nigerian's blood, a spill of blood, is not worth his ambition. And he kept to that word and stabilized our polity and democracy. Thank you for keeping to your word. Your Eminence, Sultan Saad Abubakar, the Sultan of Sokoto. At this stage, please, can I stand on the existing protocol as established by my executive governor? I'm indeed very grateful to God and our ancestors for finding me worthy to stand before you today in this our ancestral ground. I also want to thank our highly revered monarch, Omonoba Edo Okuakwolokwolo, Oba Eware II, Oba Atokpe, for giving me the opportunity and privilege amongst his very numerous and eminent, prosperous children, both at home Annie Diaspora to play this very important role, to be keyed into this very important role of being the executive producer of the Red Book. The Red Book is a compendium of history. It's a fusion of the past and present. I was really more encouraged to continue with this project by the very commitment and achievement of our very revered father, Omanoba Anedo, in the last 2 years towards his achievement in this country, in this kingdom, by driving the society and giving us values which is driven from the past. Now, I'm a believer of the past because I believe that is the past that makes the present and the future. I believe that a man that does not know or recognize his past and does not look back does not appreciate the present and does not even have an idea about what the future is supposed to be like. Because when we were growing up in this town, our parents always told us, "Don't spoil my name. Don't spoil my name." What did that mean to us? Don't spoil the past. So that past is what determines your presence. And if you don't spoil that name, you also build a future for the next generation. And that is the value that we, some of us, have grown up with, because the past drives the present and the future. So when your father tells you not to spoil his name, so wherever you find yourself, both in public service and in business, you begin to do things that will not spoil your father's name, that will build a future for your children. That is the value that you drive, because it's the past that drives the value for the future. But unfortunately, I may say, today in this country, who actually has the values of the past? How many role models are standing for our children? Today, it's the fathers that are spoiling the name for the children in our society. So, I'm a believer of the past. This book is very, very significant to me, especially because during the course of the execution of this book, I also got to find out that I was merely fulfilling a destiny. Why will I say so? Because my own grandfather, Lawrence Owese, had also written a book, a 400-page handwritten book on this kingdom in 1926. And this book was presented to me during the course of the execution of this book. When I saw it, I knew I was only fulfilling the destiny, and I brought it to the knowledge of our father with my uncle, Pataiwo Lawrence. So, this is a gift, I must say, this book, the right book. It's a gift to our generation. It's an expose of some very deep things that has not been seen. The Omonoba has given us a gift. Every child of this kingdom, every child of the South, and maybe Nigeria, and the whole world in general, a token for us to take home, for our children to read, to know where they are coming from, to know that they have a very, very rich heritage, to give them values that will drive the future. And in so doing, you will also be supporting the vision and the aspiration of the Oba Ewaye Foundation. And every Benin man, every Benin woman, both at home and in the diaspora, know that our most revered monarch will never go cap in hand begging anybody to support his vision. So he has given you something that is priceless for you to support the Oba Ewaye Foundation to realize the vision and the aspiration. Because I know that he means so well for this kingdom. Our monarch is a man of truth. And since, for the past 2 years, the community is beginning to feel, more importantly, have faith in the conflict resolution in the palace and arbitration. He has helped less privileged. He has drawn enough energy from all these communities, and things are beginning to be more prosperous in our kingdom. So I join every Benin man, every Okpia Oroba, and Okwo Oroba to support this vision. Before I end, I just want every Okpia Oroba, Okwo Oroba to stand up in this. If you are a proud Benin man and a proud Benin woman, I want you to stand up in this gathering. Okwo Oroba, Okwo Oroba. Because when you are an Okwo Oroba, it means that it's the Oba that owns you. All our energy All our strength begins and ends in this place. I just want to sing a song, and I want you to join me in this song before I sit down. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Kaveyo Baba, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo. Usunogwa badole doyi, Kaveyo.